Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, it's going to be all about how to remove backgrounds from your footage, not using a green screen, blue screen, or any chroma keying tool whatsoever. So in this video, we are going to use the bitmap inside of DaVinci Resolve 19. The bitmap were first introduced in DaVinci Resolve 18, but has since then been updated and refined a little bit, I think. So in this video, we're going to try that out so you can remove the backgrounds from your footage doing all kinds of cool things. Okay, so without further ado, that's what we're going to do for this video. So let's just jump right into the tutorial. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 19. And in this video, we're going to remove the background from this shot we have right here of this young female, because it's a pretty dull background and we want something else. So we are going to do that without using green screen, blue screen, or any chroma keying whatsoever. So let's just jump into the color page. So in the color page, we'll go up to our effects right here, and we're going to search for depth. We have the depth map here, and we're just going to add that right in here. And now DaVinci will think for a sec. And the basic idea here is to, what we want to remove is the background, so we need to make the background black. And we want to keep the girl, so we want to make her white. And to do that, we'll simply go into the resulting map adjustment. I'm going to toggle on adjust map levels. And in the far limit, I'm going to bump that up, because that is going to make the background black, like so. And then in the near limit, I'm going to go the other way and bump that down. And we're going to do this until it's almost white. Something like this. Look a little harsh, but that's what we're going to do. Then we'll go out here in the grid, right click, and we're going to add an alpha out, which is this blue here. And then we're simply just going to drag this line to the blue circle here. And that's just going to erase the background. If we toggle here, you can see that there's nothing behind her, but we can clean this up a little bit. So I'm just going to put in the bitmap preview again, and I'll go into the matte finesse, and I'm going to toggle this on. And in the post filter, I'm just going to drag that down a little bit. And now we can see there's adding in some details here around the shape here. And then I'm just going to blur that just a little bit, something like that. And I'm going to toggle off the map preview yet again to have a look. It might be okay. So let's just jump quickly here into the edit page. And here we have the girl here without the background. And we're simply just going to add in a new background, like so. So now she is in Paris instead. So that is how you can remove a background from your footage without having a green screen or using chroma key. However, there is another tool in DaVinci Resolve that's as well, or actually I think it's better. And I'm going to show you that pretty fast. And no surprise, we'll go back to the color page. I'm going to take this clip right here. And in this case, I'm not going to search for a depth map. Actually, I'm not even going to use an effect. I'm just going to use the magic mask. And I know the magic mask is a feature for the studio version, however, the magic mask is a super powerful tool that will actually, I think it's worth the money for the studio version alone. So I'm just going to draw on the girl, going to put on my little overlay so I can see what has been chosen. And if there's something I don't want there, I can simply just go to the minus here, and I'll take this little thing off here. And all I need to do now is to track forward and backward on my clip, and DaVinci Resolve will simply just do its thing. And again, I'm doing this on the faster version here in the Magic Mask. If you want a better result than this, you could go to the better option, and that is going to do a way better job. However, it's also going to require more computer power on your system. And for this tutorial, we are just going to go with the easy option for both the depth map and for the magic mask. So that is, again, two ways to do the same effect inside of DaVinci Resolve. Okay, with the magic mask done, I'm simply just going to, again, do the same as before, adding the alpha out here, going back to the edit page. And here we have a look at how that looks using Magic Mask. Again, if you want a better result, use the better options both for the Magic Mask and for the depth map. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.